the society is not so mature and civilized to adopt fully non-violence now. The society is in a very, very uncivilized status. Only few people are talking about administering or knowing about this Ahimsa Tattva. Most of the society are there in mutual Himsa. Why they are doing lot of this Himsa? Because of number one, exploitation. I told in one seminar on labor science, I told that if a labor is working for 10 rupees, if you are giving 5 rupees, then that 5 rupees is the wages and the extra 5 rupees is exploitation, which is Himsa. So the exploitation of people, not paying them or paying them less, that is also Himsa. So Himsa is not only physical torture. Squeezing the work more than what they deserve and what they demand, that is also labor rights. It is a very wonderful thing for Himsa. And labor justice is the purest form of Ahimsa. So non-violence is multifold and manifold. So exploitation, number one. And second thing is explosion. Whenever I'm angry, I have to show on people. That is explosion. That is also known as Himsa. And third thing is sadism. Wherever the persons are having psychological error of torturing others and getting that pressure, that is sadism. So exploitation, explosion, sadism and intolerance in the form of envy, hostility or disharmony, these things are the various roots of Ahimsa. So we have to start in all models. The hard model is known as teaching and training by spiritual methods and religious methods. And the soft methodology is by painting, music, dance and other forms. So we have to practice all of these forms and we have to get inspiration from living models as well as lived models and apply to the contemporary trends. Likewise, we have innumerable people. There are three people which we want to say, and today they have been discussing about the three people. A person who has met a challenge in India, and a person who met the same challenge in the West, and a person who has to meet both the challenges now in the growing society. The person who met the challenge by non-violence is Gandhi, and the person who has met the same thing inspired by great people like Howard Thurman, Bayard Rustin, and Mahatma Gandhi. These three inspirations, they created a form of Junior Martin Luther King. He was there in the West, and a person who has a responsibility to both the things, to miss both the things, to produce an anti-terrorist campaign as well as to produce a democratic, fearless society now, such a person is Barack Obama. Then we have taken these inspirations in various things. You know that Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi, by means of mass support and mass attraction, a single person maintaining non-violence is more or less than what we call imbecilism or impotentialism. A person who can command mass protest, agitation and mass support, such a person's non-violence will be obedient. It will be heard and it will be potentialized. So that is the greatness. So these leaders, they are having mass control or mass attraction or mass direction facilities. You know that Martin Luther King, each and everybody, they had their own environment. Number one, political environment, social environment, the economical situation, the impact of that speeches on the society, the mindset of the society, innumerable things, they vary. You cannot do a model for India to apply to Nigeria. For example, Democracy of India cannot be immediately made suitable to Nepal or the Burma, the Myanmar, which is suffering from military rule now. Each and everybody should make a pattern design which is very much suitable and applicable for the political trend, the moral trend, the mental trend, as well as the socio-economical factors of that country. This Martin Luther King, he has told a very good statement which is very much a spiritual in nature, not religious in nature, spiritual nature, very wonderful statement. He told about Gandhi. Gandhi's statement are very much suitable to the inherent moral structure of the universe. And it is as inescapable as the law of gravitation. See, moral structure of the universe, he told that there is a moral structure for the universe. That is a statement of Martin Luther King. What is moral structure of the universe? See, helping others or loving others is not a quality, but it is a need of survival. It is a moral structure. Now whatever we are saying is, loving others is a divine quality. Helping others is a divine quality. You will get heaven. If you help others, whether you get heaven or not, you will live in hell. That is sure. The same world, not a separate hell. If you don't help others, if you exploit, the same world will be a hell for you or for your grandchildren. So that's what he told. The whole universe is having a fabric of moral structure. Morality is not a divine quality. Morality or atheism is not a spiritual quality. Even the world has a moral fabric, a moral structure. So Gandhiji's rules are very much attachable and affiliable to the moral fabric or network of the universe. And this rule is as inescapable to follow up as the rule of gravitation. You know magnetism, you know electricity, you know gravitation. We cannot escape from these rules. Likewise, the rule of helping others, the rule of social indiscrimination and justice is a moral fabric of the world. And this rule is as inescapable as electricity. So he considered this type of non-violence and helping others and social unity, uniformity and universal brotherhood to be a physical phenomena rather than an ethical and spiritual phenomena. He considered that if you touch fire, you will be burnt. If you touch electricity, you will get a shock. If there is the mechanism of magnetism, it will attract and repel. So Martin Luther King, apart from considering this as an ethical, spiritual quality, he considered it as a physical quality of the moral fabric of the world. That is a very greatness. You know that he worked for racial indiscrimination, social justice, for labor rights, for civilian rights, for getting various other benefits of equality, equanimity and equanimity for the society. He worked and he got the Nobel Prize in such a situation where anybody cannot be getting that prize because lot of discrimination, suppression, domination and racial discrimination in the prize makings were there existing at that time. Where there is, now we can just have backdoor entry, crossdoor entry, underground entry and everything for prizes. At that time where that was not possible, wherever racial discrimination ruled at its peak, he got that which Gandhi even was refused, that Nobel Prize. He got from a very exasperated environment, he has got that. That is a very great success. Now anybody getting a prize is just getting something from a bazaar or from a grocery shop. He should have some influence, that's all. Now, at that period of 1964, when he got out of great struggle, see, he got and then achieved. His mass approach and mass control, it created a very great renaissance in the society. And after getting the Nobel Prize only, he made the US to pass the Civil Rights Bill Act of 1964 and Voting Rights Act or Bill for 1965. After getting that only, he passed all of these things. And you know that he had the very great Albany campaign, the Birmingham campaign, the Albertan campaign, the Semler campaign, and he had the very great Washington March and Poor People's campaign of 1968. He integrated the whole society to march against that type of future. So if anybody is handling non-violence, he should have three powers. One is very inspiring, soul-stirring oration. Second thing, compassionate embracement of the society. Using these three tools, two tools, the third tool is he should have got a very massive, colossal mass support for the public. He should have a very great vocabulary. Very great vocabulary means not linguistic vocabulary, psychological vocabulary, where he can feel the pulse and heartbeat of the people, where he can communicate with their hearts, not brains. So this type of special oratory. Apart from this, he should have a compassionate behavior and gelling with the people inseparably. Third thing, using these two powers, he should command respect, courage and total submission and surrender from mass. This is the quality of leadership of non-violence. Without that mere non-violence, I don't harm anybody. This is not totally useful at all. So that thing existed in these three people. These three people whom we are going to take now, they had all of these things. Now let us, in the concluding session, consider about the various differences in their periods and also some similarities. Number one, I told mass support. Gandhi also had mass support. Then Martin Luther King also had that. Barack Obama, he has also come with mass support. So mass support is okay. The second issue is, apart from mass support, technology we have to study. What was the technology there? At that time, technology's advancement was not there. Now we are having weapons of mass destruction. This issue was not there at the time of Gandhi. This issue was not so serious at the time of King. Now we are having two problems. One, weapons of mass destruction. Number two, availability of the technology, availability of the resources to non-state reactors and terrorism. The same technology, already the technology is double-ended knife and it is harmful. And this technology is very much available with the terrorists or non-state reactors more than the state reactors and politicians. That is the second problem. So now what we are facing is advancement of technology, not only in surveillance, not only in detection, not only in reconnaissance, not only in military intelligence, not only in protecting forces, in also destructive forces, we have advanced technologies and we have more accessibility for the destructors towards technology and money resources rather than political forces. That's the reason I already told. The government should take care of agriculture, it should take care of the animal husbandry, health and hygiene, it should take care of education, employment and various things along with anti-terrorism. Whereas terrorists, they have to take care of only terrorism. They don't have any other job at all. So their resources are well managed, well utilized towards